I want to show you an alternative tenoning jig that's a lot less complicated and a lot less expensive than using the THK bearing rails that you've seen me use in some of my videos. Before I got the THK bearing rails, I used this setup that I had made that slid on top of the two pieces of 12 millimeter Baltic birch with laminate on it. When I sent a fence to Mark Spagnola, the Wood Whisperer, I sent him one of my original fences, so I only had one, so this setup didn't work anymore. And so I've just recently made another batch of these high fences. They're slightly different than the original one that I made. And so I'm going to modify this now to where this setup will now work with these two new fences. So this is going to give you an alternative to spending a lot of money on and then having to fabricate and install a bearing guide setup. Because this can just be made out of scrap wood, and you're probably going to want to make a couple of these tall fences anyway, just because they are so handy for cutting tall material up on its edge. And I generally just leave one on this side, but I have the two on right now just because I want to show you how we're going to make this tenoning jig. Okay, when I made this first one, this was the tall fence that I had. This is the identical mate to the one that Mark Spagnola has, and you can see that I didn't put laminate on the back side. And me being here in Texas, we get such radical temperature and humidity changes from being really, really dry to being very tropical that, you know, I was getting some movement. And so I just decided to make a batch of 12 with laminate on both sides. And it actually ends up being easier because I had to apply multiple coats of finish to get any kind of build on this. So what I've got here is I've got these pieces of wood here. These are Liptis, and I've got, you know, very, very accurate lines drawn here at 3 centimeters apart, 30 millimeters apart. And inside that, when I did this, I sunk T-nuts from the back side. And so now I've got all these threaded receivers precisely separated here so I can attach, and they're on both sides. And so I'm going to be able to keep this top section since I've already done this work in this, and I'm just going to cut this apart and then just do a micro trim on the edge here to get this piece back, because I know it's all milled exactly square. And when I get it apart, I can show you how I do this. You know, you countersink from the back with a 3/4 inch Forstner bit. You set your T-nut in from the back. You drive it in with these prongs. And then what I always like to do, you may be able to see in here, I like to just plug it so it can't come out. I just use a 3/4 inch plug that I make on my drill press and then just drill and tap through that. So it's just a real simple way to create a real nice mechanical threaded fastener that you can take in and out hundreds if not thousands of times without, you know, boogering it up like you would with a screw. Now I'm going to do away with this here. I'm going to go with a little bit different method here because, like I said, due to humidity changes, even in plywood, you're going to get a little bit of swell and stuff in plywood. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a different setup here, and it's going to also have UHMW glide for the bearing surfaces on the side, and then what's going to run on the top. And that's what I'm gonna fabricate here today. I have plenty of UHMW scrap. It's not gonna take very much. And then I'm gonna be able to make my fine adjustments using these plastic 3/8 set screws. So let me get on with it. So the first thing I need to do is I need to cut this apart and get this ready to go again. So here was just one of the fences that I made for this, but you can see that since I've added that extra piece of laminate on the inside, that I'm off, you know, a 1/16 and a 1/16 makes this jig off an eighth of an inch. So I got to rework it for this new setup. So here I can attach these. These are just separated by exactly 30 millimeters. I can attach that anywhere and then just have this, you know, come down here. It's just going to be so much better. You know, before I was using, I just used Vaseline or mineral oil as a lubricant, but it's going to just be so much nicer now to have, you know, the UHMW riding against the plywood. And like I said, I'm only going to be using some little pieces of this. It's not going to take very much at all. The problem with the UHMW, if you start getting too big, you know, it doesn't lay flat. It's not flat. And it kind of punches out if you try to drill it. And so it can really be a bit of trouble. So whenever people make table saw faces out of it, you know, they invariably have trouble because you've got some kind of connection point that you that you're attaching to your fence, and as you connect it, you're gonna get it displace and punch and have these little ridges and stuff. It's a common problem that we hear about all the time. So it's not a very good facing material. Not like this. You know, you got Baltic birch and then you got rigid laminate on top of it. So this is to me the way to go. Not melamine. Melamine's too soft. That's low pressure laminate, but this is high pressure laminate, just regular Wilson art, and this stuff is tough and durable. It's what I make all my work tables out of, and it's really serious stuff. And cheap too, and fun to work. This is Liptis, and this is just off the charts on the obnoxious hardness scale. So this is just some, oh man, it's some serious stuff. I mean, barely pausing, you can see how it burned a little bit. This one I sped it up a little bit, and it's not quite so bad. And you can also see the, you know, where I came in here and plugged, and the backside to make sure that, you know, glued and made sure that I wasn't going to push those T-nuts out.